Hi, boys.
Doing things a bit differently this week, just trying out some new technology. So you should be watching this video on YouTube, and I've given you the link from your OneNote page during our session. This week, we're doing an amazing story. It's a terribly tragic story, but it's also very heroic. And the ultimate product for you this week is to know a bit about Tony Kurtz, know a bit about this wonderful mountaineering story. It is all over mountaineering. Any great mountaineer, any story or history of mountaineering will feature this story. Set in Switzerland in 1930s, Tony Kurtz is the man that we are going to learn about, feel terribly sorry for, but also recognize what incredible strength and what incredible bad luck he faced. The Eiger, the mountain, the huge climb in Switzerland is famous, is world famous. And Tony Kurtz and three of his mates had a go at it in 1936 and failed spectacularly. A book which involves this story called The White Spider is famous in mountaineering circles. That's what we're having a look at, some videos. And the product that I want you to make, besides knowing this story and knowing about Tony Kurtz, I think it's an important thing to know, is to build a headstone for him and to write yourself, create an appropriate epitaph. Your headstone can be done on your computer, it can be done on a piece of paper, or I hope some of you will have a crack at setting one up outside in the dirt or on a stone and make it look quite spectacular with his name, his date of birth, his date of his death, and some wonderful statement that sums up his life, or perhaps his death. The great thing about Tony Kurtz, the most tragic thing, I suppose, is that the greatest achievement in his life was the way he died, which is a bit tragic. So let's really get into this story and start to enjoy it.
Windows open to the night, your coffee's still warm. Feeling good now, looking well, being soothed by the sound of the Christchurch bell. As the hours turn, you can hear them. Repairs old watches and cuffs. Don't give him much time now. He doesn't know what's gone wrong. Keeps on moving slowly.
shirt set out to climb the north face of the island on the 20th of July 1936. He and his fellow climbers were only the second team in its history to attempt this remarkable job. Kurt was 23, a newly qualified mountain guide for Bavaria. He was climbing with his friend and fellow climber, a brilliant young rock climber called Andreas Hinterstoisser. They had joined up on the climb with two Austrians. 27-year-old Willy Angerer was the eldest. His partner, Eddie Renier, was the most experienced, a highly talented rock climber and mountaineer. Their progress up the north face that day had turned into a public event. They were being watched from the valley below by a cluster of reporters and tourists.
As you approach the bottom part of the face, you climb a series of shattered rock walls and rubble-strewn ledges. Then you get under the rope flume. It's a tiny ridge on this face, and yet it's 1,000 feet high, an overhanging wall of rock. Then round the corner to the edge of the first ice field. The second ice field is a great swathe of ice, 1,800 feet wide. It's steep, it's getting steeper, and every time from now on, you get onto the rock, it's getting steeper and steeper. Until you get right to the base of the great ice sheet called the White Spider. If you fell at this point, you would zip out into space. You probably wouldn't touch anything for 5,000 feet.
It was the scale of this vertical rock face that defeated the first climbers to attempt it.
I knew you were talking about this long before I had my own.
Below Kurtz,
I'm finished.